Hi everyone, it's Alex from Risk Academy, and today I wanted to talk about my favorite topic, inherent versus residual risk. Is it necessary? Is it useful? Is it used for anything at all? Why hasn't the term inherent risk appeared in ISO 31000 since 2009? And so on. And if... Sorry, this is... I hate this concept so passionately, but really there's no reason to hate it. It's just, you know, I grew up in Australia where inherent risk was part of the methodology for most of the consulting work done at the time. And my God, that was stupid. I mean, that was just such... That led to so many ridiculous conversations with clients that were just completely confused. So it was completely unnecessary at the time. But the simple answer is, in reality, the simple answer is inherent and residual risk, is this differentiation any good? Should you use it? The simple answer is, it doesn't matter, no one cares. If you want to, you can do anything you want. There's absolutely no reason not to do it. You just have to remember certain things. And the certain thing is, the overall concept has more emotional attachment than a scientific attachment. So, you know, measuring risk in its kind of pure form versus measuring the risk in its controlled form sounds exciting, but unless it can be scientifically precisely done, everything else is just absolute rubbish. It's not real. It's not a real concept. It's artificial at best, it's bullshit at worst. And understanding that, we have a lot of concepts that are artificial, but they're useful for us for marketing purposes. They're useful to sell the idea to executives, to prove a point, to prove a concept. So if this inherent versus residual is a useful concept to you to sell or get your message across, then by all means use it and do whatever you want. However, keep in mind that it's absolutely non-scientific, there is nothing real about it, it's absolute nonsense, and don't insist on it. If you see that the concept doesn't kind of work or it grinds a little bit and people just, you get blank faces, drop it, because it's completely unnecessary. Mainly because risk management is actually not about measuring and understanding and mitigating risks. Risk management is a decision-making tool. And to move to a better decision or to move to a more risk-informed decision, you actually don't need the concept of inherent and residual risk. It's completely unnecessary. In fact, most of the tools, decision trees, scenario analysis, sensitivity analysis, Monte Carlo simulation, and scoring mechanisms, you can easily get away without ever mentioning or even thinking of existence of concepts like inherent and residual risk. So you, it's the moral obligation is on you to justify why do you have to use a concept that is absolutely artificial. And if you have a justification for using it, good for you. Do it, nobody cares. It has absolutely no significant impact on whatever you do. But if there is no justification, that your moral obligation is to drop this rubbish and start using something more appropriate. Keep in mind that you don't have to measure risks in terms of impact and likelihood. In any case, in fact, the five tools that I've just mentioned, only the scoring requires something similar to likelihood consequence discussion. Even that can be done without likelihood and consequence ever being mentioned. All the other tools have no concept of likelihood and consequence. They measure effect risks have on their objectives in a different way. So you don't really have to use it. I'm interested in hearing your thoughts. I've seen, I mean, this is so hilarious. It's 2018, and once a year or twice a year, somebody like some dummy would post a question like that, inherent versus residual, in one of the discussion groups on LinkedIn. And it immediately becomes like one of the most popular discussions. And I'm going like, oh my God, people, you're embarrassing yourselves. You're justifying having this discussion is just is unbelievable. But anyway, I do exactly the same. I did this video. So thank you and goodbye.